Oh, and Santa is doing a nice job bringing some snow to the mountains, but that rain-snow mix down in town, which a lot of people wish for. I think we are looking northwest from our downtown studios. Is that correct, guys? Yes, that is a view we don't often see, looking kind of northwest toward north central high school on this Friday evening. Your forecast first for tonight, a slight chance of rain or snow overnight, 32 for an overnight low. I think you will encounter some slick spots on the roadways if you're heading out for Friday night fun. Those wet roads may be refreezing, and because we are going to be right around freezing, it'll be patchy. You may be on wet roads and then get into a spot where it's icy, so you have to be on heightened alert for that. Tomorrow, a chance of a rain snow mix, accumulating snow in general above 2,500 feet. Even there, we're looking at half inch, maybe an inch on the high side with a high temperature of 38. We'll do more melting than accumulating. 33 right now in Spokane. We're right at the dew point, so we're not going to drop much from our current reading. It's 32 right now with some light snow happening in Coeur d'Alene. Doppler radar shows this weakening band of mainly snow extending from Bonner's Ferry down through the central Panhandle Mountains, moving to the east and tapering off. We're going to get a break this evening before the next round of wet weather moves in. Here's our computer model forecast. Starting off at the current time, we dry out, moving off to the east, and then this next system rotates in. The computer model, here's 8 o'clock tomorrow morning, showing most of the wet weather to the west of the Spokane area and falling in the form of snow in some of the higher elevations heading up through the Okanagan. You could get in that half inch to an inch range with this system, mainly in Spokane and Coeur d'Alene. We'll see that rain snow mix and then start drying out tomorrow evening and staying dry as the storm track is continuing to be mostly to our south, very strong southern branch of the jet stream, and we are just getting sort of brushed with the dregs of these systems as the bulk of the moisture is staying well to our south and is going to be even more so as we get into the extended forecast. Overnight lows tonight, right around freezing to just above. So again, be on alert for sneaky spots on the roadways where things are freezing. And then tomorrow, everybody's up above freezing, 39 in Spokane Valley and in Coeur d'Alene, 40 degrees tomorrow in Lewiston, in the 40s also in Moses Lake. Here is your 7-day forecast. I have a 2 on the weather impact scale for the potential of some icy roads in the morning and a little bit of wet weather throughout the day. We dry out for Sunday. And then look at those high temperatures continuing to gradually get colder. But we do have some chilly nights ahead. We've been kind of spoiled with fairly warm overnight lows. Yeah. And the teens, you're going to feel that.
Mm-hmm. Cut right through you, right?
Yes. If you haven't put that extra blanket on the bed, you might need to do that soon.
Yeah, close the shades on the windows, too. Keep that warm air inside.